May 13th, 1940, The Hague, seat of government of the Dutch nation, was supposed to be neutralized 3 days ago by an advanced airborne operation. As you're well aware, this is not the case. Not only have our forces failed to capture the Dutch queen and force a surrender, but now they're in danger of being wiped out completely by advancing Allied troops. Your objective is to succeed where they have failed, to secure The Hague, and the surrounding objective is to force the Dutch to surrender. If at all possible, link up with and protect any surviving auxiliary German forces you encounter. Their survival would do much to bolster your prestige in the eyes of high command. Wow, that's a second one already. Which is really nice, but I have to keep selling them in the hopes of getting another infantry, I guess. Still, it does much to bolster my prestige. I can give you regulars. Regulars. One of the things that I dislike a bit now about using recon like this is that because I need to get them to the amount of stars continuously, you can't use them as punching bags like you would otherwise, because now I have to give them elites, for example. Where's... They're actually... Huh. Both of those need that. I think in the case of these three, it's pretty interesting. I actually wouldn't mind getting these up to 2 stars. And the same actually applies here. Just gonna give those 2 elites. But the question is, do I want to give elites to the engineers? I don't think so. I really don't think so. Alright. Could buy myself another fighter, start getting experience for those. I think that would be a pretty reasonable idea here. And buy the next tactical bomber. So that would be a bit of a fresh start for those. Yeah, let's just start deploying in a bit. Alright, just quickly doing the deployment here because I have a very short period of time, but I still kind of feel like doing this. I'm going to deploy the new fighter. And one 10D. I'll also deploy those. Okay, so there are basically 2 ways I want to go around Rotterdam. Not only do I want to get through this, but also around through here. The SC infantry got one star of experience. That's nice. These guys are very close. That's also nice. By this stage, I have almost everything up to one star, I guess. I wonder if the game will allow this to turn into a hetzer, but really not sure. 26, 33. These guys get slow experience, but nothing to be done about it here. They're almost one. They are at one. And just trying to position my units in such a way that it will make them most useful. The SE Grenadier is almost up to 2 stars of experience, which is also really nice. The Panzer III will also go up. I have 2 artillery down and 3 artillery up. These have only 4 movement, so that is something I also want to think about. The Panzer III can move through up here. It's fine that they got to 1 star of experience, but to be honest, if I'm gonna deploy a recon, I'd rather get these. This is just... yeah, even this is just no good. I'm pretty much about ready to give this up and move these guys through down, try to save them. These guys will stay in place. Certainly we'll give this away, but especially with this, I feel like you can get a nice amount of surrenders there if you're fast enough. I think I'm also going to deploy the Panzer 38T. Let's get you here, cavalry here. I have 1 more unit, huh? I could deploy the Pionier or Junkers 88s. I think I'm better off just getting the bomber here. All right, that would be my setup. Yeah, I don't need to overstrengthen them yet. I I'd rather just keep them at 10 strength for now, and the this mission is marginally difficult. Although I think Albert Canal is more so ultimately. It's really funny, I think, also, you can see this here, which is really not supposed to be here during time of the war. This was just all water. So you can clearly see that they've been using new maps. But, alright, that's it for the deployment. I'll meet you back for play. Alright, let's get started. Yeah. Put these here for a reason. What are your regular suppress chances? 30, huh? And yours? 54. It's a pretty big difference. Are you one star now? No, that only gives them 2 experience. Dang it. Yeah, let's use a strategic bomber there. Wow. They seem to be needing at least the resuppression in order to have a average non-counterattacking kind of chance, I'd say. Shame they can't get in there. They do have the tank. So, technically speaking, I can already not get past all of that, but... They can still pull back. Yeah. Which is probably the best there. Yeah, let's have them move. These are infantry without trucks, and probably I'll use this to move further ahead, and 1, 2, 3, 4, so they can actually move further. because breaking out here is pretty tricky. Not only do you need to either defeat the Matilda or the infantry, if I move them here, it's like 1, 2. I would need to have the Stuk here, and I'd need at least 1, 2, 3 units like that. And these guys need to be beaten. So it's pretty tricky to get past everything there. The only unfortunate thing is I know they have like a fortress here, or the strong points, which has 4 visions, so they can pretty much see everything up to that. Which is pretty tricky. Let's keep those Fallstrom generators. How many did I need to keep? 4. Okay. Let's get you out. I do remember from playing this like, I don't know, 500 years earlier, that this position here eventually will get lost, even if you put both of them in here. If I'm not mistaken, they'll keep units there, so I'd rather have them try to join the rest. Them retaking the hexes also means that I can get prestige from it, if I retake it again, say. That means I probably only need 1 more. Yes, indeed. Should have used the 110C for that and the D for bombing. Actually, that would have given me a better result ultimately. These are big rivers, so they're not going to give me. Necessarily what I want. I don't think they're gonna move in here basically. I don't think that's how it's gonna work, but we'll see. 5-2, huh? Do that then. I mean, if they die, they die. That's a lot better than I have to worry less about that. I'm going to move these guys back up, because now that I've destroyed the tanks, or the tank here, there's no use for these down there. I don't think. They'll probably have mostly infantry at this point. think dealing with the artillery is probably going to be quite important. If they get artillery on this position, that's going to be real bad. I actually don't want to attack this. I don't see the use in attacking them right now. Rather, I'll just do this. And that. Okay, they might actually try to attack this. Again, the Matilda here is actually the trickiest part, probably. And for them to repair it, it also means, you know, it will cost them a lot of prestige here. Now I can go out though. The question is just, is it useful to try and go that way? If they have more tanks, then it might not necessarily be. But I don't have another recon here now. Yeah, it's a bit sucky, but do you also do 1 damage? I guess so. Or not. Need to keep damaging these. The problem here is that well, basically, I'm not going to destroy that strong point, obviously, so I need to take that with the recon. Anyhow. Yeah. They can't see the infantry. Or the artillery. Should think I'd be fine, and it does help me set up for next turn. Actually do this. Okay, so they can see the cavalry. And they can even see this, but they'll just repair. Yeah, let's actually move you here. If they are static, that's okay. So they did go after the artillery, huh? Interesting. Pretty bad roll, but... two, three, four, five, six. Written here is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, they would only be able to go there then. Not quite sure if I think the 3x11 is okay. But let's take Dordrecht here. At least I'm dealing massive damage because they decide to put these kind of units onto the river. It's really dumb. As it is as well, these guys are having a difficult time, I guess, in here. I would have to, yeah, even if I push them into that hex, those tanks, it would still give me trouble. So basically, I will push them back in here, that way. Yeah, and then I need to get another unit on a place like that. Or at least on this hex. Or not. Certainly I'm taking it back. Artillery here. At least one here. Destroying this at least reduces their field of vision. And that might actually be the correct play, but then these guys can still see everything here. So that would be pretty tricky. Hmm. One thing I can do here. Wow. Really? On the one that they are not suppressed? Man, I'm having a bad day here. From the cavalry, too. Wow. What poop. Alright. Alright, I get it, game. That's how you want to play, huh? There's no doubt in my mind that this Hotchkiss is gonna try and be a bitch. But I can't reach it. And I'm not so sure, hey? Let's at least try to damage it. Maybe it will repair. At least it will help a little bit. With that being at 8, I feel like I... Ah, Pope. Come on. Yes. Okay, that at least helps. That deals with the Matilda. Now, the only serious thing around this area is this Hotchkiss over here. You have no attacks from that position. So basically, I cannot. Keep it as a forward position. Pretty much just have to do this to shield both of them. Now that things are basically like this, as silly as it is, I kind of feel like shifting back is probably the way to go. 1, 1, 2, 3. If they move in here, that's okay. What's your movement for? So 1, 2, 3, 4. So they could attack this artillery if I put it here, unfortunately. And well, the thing is, it's probably even fine. If they have a stronghold here or here, it's like 1, 2, 3, 4. They wouldn't be able to see it out of hand. Yes. So, because of this infantry, they can still see that, and destroying the strong point makes no sense at that point. But it also means they can always just go in regardless of whether I move in there, although they can also do that now with these. So I might just as well try this. Five times 22. It's actually marginally likely to do more damage than I would like. You have 5 movement? Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. I mean, some units are unprotected, like these, in terms of AA, but I cannot protect everything at this point, really. War, huh? Going after the AA next would allow me at least to... that's no good. Man, yeah, let's just keep both. No. That was really stupid. Wow. Because at least them wide exposed there. Yeah, I think killing this tank is probably well worth it. These guys have it tough enough, so... That's actually really good, I think. I know that they actually did nothing. Huh. Interesting indeed. Those attacks are not particularly great. They do seem to leave these alone. Really? 1 times 22 still, huh? Because... Oh. Really? That's 100% not what I wanted to do. Fine. 8-8. Because they'll go here. Oh no, they stay there. I guess... I don't think these guys are gonna cause a whole lot of ruckus at this point with two strength, so I can start taking that down. Eight times five, seven times seven. I'd rather have them hit the infantry than the tank, although the tank also can't really move anywhere else. These can at least attack at that. Four times seven. I'm gonna have to take a hit with something. I guess the Panzer 4D is gonna do it. They're the furthest away. Yeah. I could follow it up with the Panzer III, although I might actually want to do that there. At least it didn't take a hit. They're at 3 suppression. How much damage would you do? 4. Let's see, you here, you there. Means I. This would put them there, so I would need to get you in here, you here. Man, like I said, I'm having pretty bad luck here. Again. That just really sucks. The infantry, you here, come on, give me some decent suppression. 7-3. I mean, I can kill it afterwards with the Luftlande, so let's just. Come on. Can we get a decent die roll here, please? Just once. Oi, oi, oi. No, I can't. I straight up can't. I have to say that, yeah. I mean, I know it sounds complainy, but having like almost every single die roll go bad is not great. Like, they're all doing worse than the predicted outcome. It's just very annoying. Yeah, it just really sucks. Not going to go down this time. Kill the strong point. We'll attack this infantry so I can at least get them off my back for a turn. They don't need to die here. That is fine. But I. This is rather tricky because basically what I'm going to be saying here, well, if I move these down here, they can still take this and I can still do that. And then I'm just assuming that fortification is 2 movement, right? Fortifications. Fortification is Infantry. Oh, it's one movement anyhow. Oh. Yeah, okay, well then they might be able to attack this if they do use one of those two, but I have no saying at that now. I also don't know if one of these might try to go out. I don't think those do. Really? Also two damage? Really? At least that went well. Not even gonna say anything. Yeah, there we go. That was bound to happen. Like, I do think, again, with my play is sound here, but just these losses are... I really don't think they're supposed to do two. Eh, maybe actually. It's a real shame. Well, now I'm basically hurting because these guys are not here to protect them. That kind of sucks at this stage. Because now the artillery is pretty weak. Two times eight, huh? Yeah, exactly. So these two hit on the two times eight. But, oh well. Sometimes things don't go your way, despite the play being fine. Claim it doesn't really matter which one of the two I attack. Well, let's soften them up first anyway. 5 and 1. I don't think this 5 and 1 is gonna cut it. No. Rather. Fuck. If they want to go and attack this, they could be my guest. I don't really mind. Ooh, don't have an airfield close enough. That's because of this one. I have to give these elites too, so it's going to be pretty costly. But I don't know for each turn when, you know, they're gonna have fighters coming along. I can't protect everything every single turn. So. Okay. I don't need to worry about attacks from here. Though it's unlikely I'll be able to make a surrender there. I would have to get in here with these. They're at 4. There's not going to be a surrender. 3, 2, and I don't have another artillery at that point. So that ain't gonna happen. It's too far for you. Right. But you would have to go down even to attack those. If I want to move in here, you here, you here. It definitely would mean I have to give this up. You there. There, then I could do it. Maybe that would be for the better. Because I'm not taking it back with these guys there anyway. Alright. Just like that. Put these here. Yeah, that's fine. Please at least surrender. Thank you. I'm not gonna be able to kill that, so I actually problem is this one, cause well, let's start here first. So let's just move you up. That's pretty tricky. So I could put these there too afterwards, but then the question is, oh, you're going all the way around. Kill them. It's a shame you cannot go in there. I'll leave you. Even reach it. I'm very curious as to 5 times 9. But Let's just go. No, right. Oof. Come on. Okay, so I've gotten a little bit pessimistic about my my chances, generally. I need to actually attack these. Tank, huh? These Hotchkisses actually have quite good stats. 5-4. I mean, that's... pretty high, I think. So hopefully that neutralizes the threat to these. Kinda should, I guess. I do think these guys would actually attack if my unit got close. One thing I could do, if I move you here, yeah, basically I can never get there, basically. Yeah, if I shell them. I already thought there was no way there was going to be those odds. Got them almost. I have nothing that can kill them now, huh? Even though I think the attack wasn't even that bad. Only these guys can go in there now. Yeah, if nothing with which to kill it. Yeah, sucks. But at least maybe it saves the artillery. They can see those. But yeah, I was already afraid of that. Still went for it. I kind of hope they would have tried to repair. Well, I can still use it to de-entrench enemy units, so it's not too bad. These are, I guess, pretty static then. That's how it looks like, at least. Tch, 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 tch. don't have two recon units, unfortunately, or I would have gone for the surrender. And I can't go all the way around here. That seems unlikely. Take a bunch of these hexes. Okay. Next. Actually move these down and thought they might not be visible anymore. We'll see how that goes. I could technically move them in here, but then they'll surely die, although that's not really something that I'd want. And by doing this, this actually denies them the ability to get to the artillery. I still think this artillery can serve a purpose here by the entrenching units up there. Did you get a... Oh, you got a plus one attack here, alright. It's a shame, yeah, you cannot go up, but... Sweet. Rather wanted to have the Panzer 4D do the honors. They do need to get to 1-star of experience anyway. Wow. I was hoping to kill these, but now I'm just absolutely getting demolished by these rolls still. Safe is that? I can still just push them in there with the grenadiers. I could probably go and take Utrecht with these reserve units now. No, they'll just take damage, and these guys are gonna attack anyway. These guys are probably even gonna die now because of these frickin' rolls. I can't even protect them. Oh, shit. Thing I can do, I think, is go here. Nothing else I can put in here. I'd rather put something here, even by truck. No. I guess I just have to attack then. Huh. Oh, at least that worked out. Because otherwise I think these would have surely died already. If you cannot reach the airfield, I'm going to take that back. I'm just gonna go for the thing that's most expensive. Also gives me a bit of vision. I don't think they have a whole lot. They might have an infantry there though. Something like that. You up attacking again, most like. Oh, you. Don't retreat, please. Thank you. Oh. At least they all survived. These guys did nothing. Again, I'm gonna assume taking back that airfield in time. I could also, yeah, again, I don't have to reach. I really need that airfield then. what are your odds? 1 times 7 against this. 4 times. Okay. I actually don't care about this artillery anymore. If they want to repair that artillery, it's fine. I can even maybe get like a surrender or something. It is not important. The nice thing is I have the Sturmpanzer to back up some of those units, which also really helps. One of the more unfortunate things, in a sense, is that that Hotchkiss is pretty close. So they have, again, indeed more armor. Alright, well, let's start with this. And I have a sensation these guys are going to take excessive damage even at the start, like they're already doing again. And I won't get very far with these, most likely. Yeah, do need the airfield though. Push them in here. Get wrecked because of the bad rolls. it seems to be a common theme now. Yeah, I cannot reach it, and this attack is just 2 times 31. I don't have any bombers. You have 3-on-1, but I'm a bit afraid of that that unit up there. I will take. The thing is that I cannot get any. 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess that could go here, but that's very far. Could do that. I'm just not sure where their artillery was. There, huh? At that point, I can do this. Hmm. They'll do a damage to either the panzer, either panzers. So I will take one damage in the process. And that bomber is also going to be around. So I need to do this too, which looks ridiculous. If I try to soften them up, 11 times 4? Oh, they have 110 rate of fire, huh? I cannot attack this regardless. I might try to deal with this. Sad part is that if I go here and attack that, even though the attack might look okay, even though it doesn't, I have the problem that this Hotchkiss can then go there and attack that infantry and deal massive damage. And now it will probably just go after this Luftlande division. Ah. That kind of sucks. I need both ammo then. Ugh. Okay, I have to say I'm not too happy mostly about the situation. Yep. Ah, come on. Fucking hell. Even with a rate of fire of 110, the predicted outcome is zero. Jesus. I know I'm complaining a lot, but this RNG is also fucking killing me. It's just... Our tank, huh? The Dutch have surprisingly many tanks. Which is not particularly historical, but... That's okay. I might be able to give them regulars, given their high experience. Should be great. At least that Hotchkiss did exactly what I wanted it to do. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Yeah, I can kill all of them probably. But no ammo is not going to be super amazing with that. Great. Beautiful. So you definitely need to be out of sight. I have to say, it kind of feels like my unit's getting a bit exhausted here, too. Either way, really need to deal with that artillery here. And then I can surrender probably even quite a few units. This will not not back out, so I might just as well start attacking here already. Yeah. Because it means that the suppression will be easier later on. Again, I chose the wrong one. Might not be able to kill the Hotchkiss. Might not even be able to kill the bomber, which would be a lot worse. To put you somewhere, so start attacking there, then you're back. You there. Just attacking again is reasonable, but then I am again with the problem of this Hotchkiss. A good hit though. Come on. Okay. You up, shall the artillery. Shall the infantry. How are you so deeply entrenched? Nine, what the heck? Okay. Then I would basically need the Stuk to attack that. Which. First. They will still have a sizable number of units here, even with me killing all of them. My hands get very itchy from this. It's just unbelievable. Really. Okay. No really good target for you guys now, except I want to take a look if there's something here. There's a 5 strength Dutch infantry. Okay. Would like to take those hexes, but. That attack went well. More infantry. Ooh, I really need to get you guys out then. If I even can, fuck. That's some serious attack coming from here. Rainy weather. He even got a suppression going. Great. Let's actually use you. I can probably use these two to go and attack that and take it. To be very tricky otherwise. They have a lot of airfields up there. I think they also had a unit in here still. You need fuel and ammo. Again, that actually does not look great. Get the surrender. Kill the artillery. That's a pretty big boon. I can put you in here. Well, that's why I wanted them in there. Kill that Hotchkiss. Now, I have to gamble as to where those guys are gonna go. I really wouldn't know. It could be this or this. I guess I could take a chance going here. Hope to get lucky. But it's certainly no guarantee. They're out in the open, but they shouldn't be visible. They could get fuel and ammo, but this is not a good place. So let's move you back in here. Up. How many did I need to save? At least four. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. As long as those four don't die, I should be able to get the decisive victory. I should give you fuel and ammo. These should go up, but not... What are they going to throw at me at this area? Not tanks, I guess. Moving here is too slow. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. It's tricky, but they cannot see it, so... You guys have 3 out of 3. If I'm lucky and they repair that, that'd be great. They have 2 out of 3, but should still be fine. I also still need to take this Ockenburg. Although, as it is with those tanks, I might actually want to keep them here for now. Is that useful? Yeah. My units are just poor, huh? Yeah, if you don't even have 1 star of experience, I guess you're liable to get hurt. Take them to 8, right? Yeah. Holy smokes. What was that? Jesus. Now they had 8. 8 is actually quite high. So never mind. I'm gonna go down there. Oh, they did go there. Funny. Also like the hit on that. They're quite drawn out, so pretty happy about that too. Take the airfield. I actually do want to push them into the city, so I want to attack from this side. It's not going to be surrender, especially because of this infantry out here. No, you'll be without ammo. So let's go up. They could just be killed. No, actually, I don't want to push here because of the artillery. Indeed. artillery is actually quite troublesome. Well, in combination with these other infantry pieces still, because they do limit my movement capabilities quite a lot. Again, I don't have any mobile units. Not looking to kill these yet. If they repair me, it's not that bad, but... Yeah, I have no artillery. I could put you in there, let them shell this. That's probably for the better. I'm gonna go down, I think, right? It should go here, yeah. Two times 12. Took the SE infantry because I felt like I can give them regular replacements regardless, because I already knew that I was going to take the damage on the 2x12. Certainly not attacking that. Really? You wouldn't say so. Necessarily. What can they see and does bomb that's really relevant? Tanks. Not that much else, really. And it's probably not a good idea to have these out. So don't really have any use for them here. Can't protect most of that stuff. Just give you fuel and ammo. Nice. A Matilda? What you attacking? Wow. Huh, well, they'll die. Nice, you're getting out of the entrenchments. Very happy about that, too. Huh. I guess... another counterattack. Need to get up here, even though they don't have a lot there. It's... interesting. Super good hits against their air force here. Yeah. It must cost them the earth to keep repairing that, so I'm very happy with the fact that they have to keep repairing that. You here, you down. I don't think they're gonna move. I hope they're not gonna move. Let's actually still use that Luftlande division. You get fuel and ammo. You need fuel and ammo. You need fuel and ammo. I'm exhausting that stuff left and right. Okay. Unbelievable. Okay. At least it gives me the opportunity to surrender that. I actually want to get these out. Didn't I have a Exodex on this map? Thought I had an Exodex on this map. I don't have an exit map on this map. I guess I forgot to save. Like, sad, really. Okay, well. Okay. Yeah, that's rather a disappointment. I can damage that thing, so that's fine. It's just about what am I gonna put in here, then Stuck here. Yeah, I cannot get you in there. But I'm not that likely to attack this Dutch infantry. Oh. I also don't know if they have AA up there. They'll just repair the Matilda, so at least there's that, but... Huh. What next? Going up there is no good. They're not sending anything down, at least. Get you here so they repair, and then I can use the 88s to finish them off. Over here, do this, give you fuel and ammo. They can shell it and attack it again, I guess. Fuel and ammo. That will set me up nicely, and I actually need these guys here for surrenders. Let's move you up. Okay. Oh, what? Oh, come on, really? That was my mistake. Super dumb. They moved, that's nice. They did move. Wow. Okay. Yeah, that was my bad. Super stupid. Alright. They didn't repair the Matilda, huh? Interesting. One thing that's a bit sucky here now is that they got in there. I'm actually not too happy about that. Move. I guess after dealing with this, then I'm set to move to those two areas. So, yeah, that's okay. The one, two, three, four, five, six. That would be a movement of six. I would certainly need to kill them first. And best way to do that is this, or not? Can actually use that to my advantage. Very likely just to repair. Weather forecast is not amazing, but okay. Gonna try and lure them out. Well, okay, wow. Oh boy. I wonder if they just bought that. And I also still don't know if they have AA there, so. They still have targets here, so it doesn't matter if they go back for a bit like that. Okay, great. Kind of. have to say that this weather now is not so great. Like these odds. Still. Effectively, it means I need to get them to surrender. Just like that. Start that way. And with these. Can get a surrender on this infantry, which is, I guess, nice. Here. Five times eight, huh? This is 8 times 31, which is, and this is 'll to them. That's probably one of the last of their regular, say, units. Yeah, I have no other units with which to make it surrender now. Just have to accept the damage. Okay. do remember that they had like only an AA there. But I do think, though, that this is enough to deal with that. So I have a mind. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh yeah, I can do this. Very nice. They will not be able to build any more units here, so they will forfeit the Hague at least. Let's move you back. Seems like they did buy units now. I really feel sometimes like the AI buys stuff really, really fast in with this. Which I'm actually not super excited about. Not gonna lie. Do I think I even have a shot at taking this down? Maybe. I'll have to see. Least. Let's also deal with the anti-air. So I can actually bomb in here. I already knew that the attack was not going to be good. It was very obvious, I think. From where I'm standing. I actually don't mind having the recon in a place like that, but the biggest problem is the ammunition. One, two, three, four. I can really only get it up in here. Meanwhile, they are going to keep buying garbage. Putting them there does expose them. But it shouldn't be that bad. One other thing that needs to go is these destroyers, because they can actually attack my unit at The Hague once I capture it. Yeah, a bit of a problem. I can't really attack with the GU. Yeah, I don't feel like I'm in danger of not getting decisive, but Shame. Yeah, I'd rather not take the risk, so. I'm getting only movement heroes here. That's actually quite nice. I can turn them into grenadiers too, then. That'll be very useful. Haha. I can also take back that hex that way. You need fuel and ammo. Wow. Chance of getting an artillery surrender are tempting me, but I don't think. One, two, three, four, yeah. That's not going to be a thing. Like I said, I'm fairly confident about my ability to get a decisive victory here. But I'd have to put these guys in here. Yeah. The 1x26 is, I guess, too high. 1 and 3, huh? Yeah, my attacks on that are not too great. I don't think they're gonna move these. But... That's actually a very bad idea. Whoops, I really messed up. Wow. You also always only see it after the act. In that case, I'm gonna have to do something painful. I'm not gonna take any of these other cities, maybe one. So... Yeah, so it would have been turn 17. Like, because of their buying here, what else could I possibly do? It's not that much. Maybe, like, take this indeed, 12 prestige. That's probably not really worth it, either way. Same here, like, I'm just not gonna take it, I think. I think I played reasonably well, but except this last thing here. But the rolls were not favorable on this one, quite sadly. So I took quite a few hits. I did get a plus one movement hero on these, so that's very useful. We'll see how bad the damage is, Congratulations, Sir General. The Dutch have surrendered, and Hans Graf von Sponeck sends you his personal thanks for your timely rescue of him and his men. Well done. Now that the Low Countries have been subdued, your forces are being diverted south to lead the breakthrough into France. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.